I did this demo about an hour ago, and I just compressed the video, ready to upload it. But for some reason it went wrong. It only recorded the end of this, plus a lot of other stuff I've been mucking about. So it's across a lock, it's a Scottish lock, typical. And I'm going to do it again, but I'm not going to do it from the photograph that I work from. I'm going to do it from the demo. So we'll see how we get on. Let's come up. Zoom out. So I've just quickly drawn it out. Now, get my bag out again. The Ziploc bag. Keeps the paint nice and too moist at the moment because I've got a lot of new paint in there. So we've got lemon yellow, raw sienna, alizarin crimson, light red, ultramarine, burnt umber, Payne's grey, and burnt sienna. I don't use a lot of burnt umber, don't know why. I don't use a lot of alizarin, but it's a very useful colour for clouds. So the paper is Fabriano, £130. This one wet, very nice and wet. And then I'll give it a coat of warm paint. Bit of blue in the sky. I want it quite wintry, although not snowy winter, but autumn, late autumn. So, bit of sienna and a bit of alizarin, I think. All over the water. So we're putting a little bit of glue on there. Put that in the water there. And I'll mix a bit of light red from the clouds with the ultramarine. Put in a bit of light through the middle there, but this nice and right. Okay, that'll do. I'll give that a little bit of a dry. So take your headphones off. Oop, turn it on. Reclip the paper, no need to stretch it. It's the Fabriano, £130 weight as usual. So we'll start off with distance and put in a bit of sienna in with that. Well, that's the furthest one, and as we come in, right, a bit more blue in there, I think. And then nearer still, so a bit of burnt sienna, it was blue. And this is where we want to add colour, warm colour. want harder edges on here. Paper's nice and dry now. Let's take a little bit of dry brush. Now, as you work in these mountains, add colour. Otherwise, it will look monotonous. So there's a little bit of green down there. This is not going to turn out to be the same as the other one. They are never copy slavishly. Just have fun with your paint. Do things that are outrageous, or appear to be outrageous. Take risks, try different things. I do love raw sienna, burnt sienna. Now we want some dark on there, on the horizon there. Well, that top of this hill. So. Just separate it from the background. Bit of green in there, I suppose. Why not? Coming in there. Separates the back. But we'll have just a bit of blue on there. Just to send it back a little bit. And we'll add some foreground trees. When I say foreground, I mean this bit I'm painting there. Let's just put that in there. But remember, when you're painting wet in wet, if you want something to really show, you've got to put it in thick. So it's quite hard to do if you let your paints dry too much. Let's change the colours of that. Using little bits of a brush, this brush doesn't stay together, but it does other things. Now, I reckon I could probably get away with a little bit of that. A little bit of rocky stuff in there. Let's have a look, let's get the card. Find it. I've got loads of cards. I'm always mislaying. What was I going to say there? Oh, well, there it is. That's a bit odd. So let's just put a little bit of a bit of scraping in, a bit on the old back here. Basically, it's on Loch Maree, but I like to add these rocks in it. It just adds a little bit of detail, a bit of outcrop here. But that'll do. So that'll do, and then do a bit more. Now I'm going to quit, isn't it? Right, let's just. Oh, I don't like that. Fill that in again. Well, we've got a nice lot of colour in there. Now we're going to put this other one in across here. I hope this is still recording. Shout loud if it's not. The one I did yesterday, that's wrapped up going to America. That's going to a cousin who does support my work, loves my what I do. I'm not using Payne's Crane this so far. So I'm going to put nice trees on top of that. Just get this rocky bit coming down here. Yeah, plenty of colour. Come down to there. There's another hair sticking on there. Coming around here. Nice green. It's all really rich, thick paint now. I'll put the reflections of this in later. While we're at it, let's just get a bit of dark on that foreground. Little trees up here. Doing this. This paint is almost tube consistency at the moment. Try it. Otherwise, your paintings will be wishy-washy if you just use it straight. Well, if you've diluted too much, it's a mixture of both, hard and soft. I'll put some rocks in there. Let's get that nice and dark in this. Horizon here. A tiny bit of water on there as we come out into this, into the loch. Oops. Careful. Right, okay, let's put in a few little bits and pieces on there. This is closer, so these rocks will just be a little bit larger. There's a little tiny bits now going into distance. Just adds a little bit of character to it, a bit of detail. I don't know whether it exists or not, but it's such fun. Just put it in, just little bits. Right, okay. So that'll do for that for the moment. That's why I changed my mind. I can put a little bit of strength on there. Now I haven't used my Payne's grey. My darks are just the blue. The brown, the yellow, and other bits and pieces. Just got a bit of dry brush over there. Okay, now I'm not going to show much reflection. I'm going to put a bit of dry brush on that. But down the bottom here, I'm going to put a bit of a bank in there. Some trees. Second, a bit of red, a bit of blue, a bit of water, a bit of this and that, really. And just some trees, just we're looking over the tops of these trees. They're a bit stronger than that. Look, lovely and thick. Rob Rands would be proud of pages. I go back a long time with Rob Rands and big brush watercolours. But I left it alone for a long time in favour of oils. But I have to say, watching Stephen Cronin really brought me back into the watercolour fold and the ache. It's such great fun. Look, there's so much. I can all my money on those sables, which I haven't used. I'm just on the bank here.
a bit of rocky stuff.
So I'll finish with the rigger. Okay, that'll do. Get the bit stronger one here. Totally different. I'm not really copying the other one, I'm just painting from sort of memory. Just this will be covered up by the mat. I'm going to try that. Headphones off, on. Got to put all the detail on the water, yeah? Right, there we go. I've got my little, one of my pots, the brushes. That's the big sable, the new one. That's the number 8. No, it's not, it's number 4. This is number 8. And this lovely number 3. And so we'll mix a dark colour. You need quite a bit of water when you use a rigger. That one, let's do the other one. Now these specimens of trees don't exist in reality, that's just my idea of an improvised tree, just to support the foreground really, or support the rest of the picture. Just a bit of anchoring on the bottom here. Okay, I'll use a bit of the grey in there. Let's just. Well, some strength in the branches here. Strengthen up some of this. You do with that, all that you can do with the rigger. I haven't finished with this area yet, but I'm going to just give it a dry. I'm going to put in some reflections. Hold your ears. Right, clean brush, clean water here. Ah, that's not very clean, is it? That's terrible. Ruined. just get a bit of dark in there. Just to catch a bit there. Now it's clashing in between, haven't it? Right. And a bit of dry brush. I don't like that. That's gone bad, isn't it? Right. Let's show the reflections of that background. Don't overdo this. Okay, that'll do. That's gone badly wrong then. Because I didn't clean my brush. Just want to put a bit of detail in there. It's not on the blue side. Right, okay. Right, well, it's what it is. I don't think it's anything near as good as the previous one, but I'm sorry you missed it, but at least you've seen what it was, and I'll show it to you at the end. I was going to put a little figure on it. Now, right, signature. I've got a little pen. Right, put a bird in. That was going well at one time. And to be really mad, I'll get my little white paint here. Put it on the palette, on my big palette. And just put in a couple of little yachts with the white there. Give it a bit of scale. Right, that'll do. Put it in the clear mount, the light coloured mount. So I've had a good and a bad day, really. The first one was, I thought, was quite good, and this one is not so quite good. So, well, there we are, I think that's too bad. A little figure just looking out across the lock. Right, let's bring you round and we'll have a little look. It just hasn't got the character of that one. This is quite limpid. I've got the balance, I think, the balance of the of the thick and thin paint on that one. Here I've gone a bit heavy. But anyway, I'll upload it and you've seen what it should have been. So thanks for watching. I'll just take you in and have a little look around the place. Right, there are a couple of little boats. The distance and that middle distance there. Quite a bit for the imagination to put in, and I'll probably overwork the foreground, but hey, that's not so bad. So thanks for watching, see you soon, bye bye.